So, Pastor, obviously, you've probably gotten a firestorm of reaction to what was said in your sermon. What's your response?
Well, you know, let me start by saying that I don't regret anything that I said, and I don't take back anything that I said. I do think that most people out there have not listened to the sermon in its context and are basically just taking what the media is portraying. And the media, for the most part, is just flat out lying. When they're putting out reports saying that I'm calling for people to take up arms against homosexuals or that I'm trying to get people to go out and do things like this, well, that's just completely a lie. Because if you listen to the sermon, you know, several times I stated that this is not something that we are to do. This is not something that we're supposed to go out and do. And I was telling people that we shouldn't be doing these things, taking this into our own hands. The point that I was making is that the Bible teaches that these people deserve to die. God puts the death penalty. And there's many places in Scripture, but the one I like to reference just because it's clear is Leviticus 20:13, where the Bible says, if a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, both of them have committed abomination, they shall surely be put to death, their blood shall be upon them. Also in Romans 1, it says, they that commit such things are worthy of death. The point that I was making is this: if God puts the death penalty on it, God says they deserve to die, and then they die, this is not something that we as Christians need to be mourning. In the same way that this gunman who went in there and killed all these people, he violated Scripture. God says that he deserves to die for taking their lives. We don't need to be mourning his death either. That's the only point that I was making. I wasn't saying that we need to go out and do this. I wasn't even necessarily saying that we need to celebrate it or whatever. I was just saying this is not something that we as Christians need to be, you know, mourning or being sad about. And the main focus of the sermon, which is what was completely ignored by the media, is that the government and the media is going to be using this event to push their agenda, which is to take away gun rights, which is to limit freedom of speech, which, I mean, the fact that you're here is proving that. Because in America, you're no longer allowed to have an opinion. In America, you're no longer allowed to say anything that doesn't follow what mainstream media tells you you're allowed to say, or else, you know, they're going to take your sermon off YouTube, or they're going to try to shut down your website, or whatever. So the point that I was making is, even though the government's going to use this to push their agenda against Bible-believing Christians and just normal people, we need to not be intimidated. And I was just calling for normal people to stand up and say, you know what, enough is enough. We're sick and tired of it. We think it's disgusting, and we're not going to mourn it. It's not a tragedy, because they deserve to die.
And you're saying that the media just kind of interpreted what you say, and I just transcribed a portion of your sermon, and you said, 50 pedophiles were killed today. No, I think that's great. I think that helps society. You know, I think that Orlando, Florida is a little safer tonight. You also went on to say the tragedy is that more of them didn't die. I mean, the tragedy is I'm kind of upset that he didn't finish the job.
So would you say if 50 pedophiles not dying is a bad thing?
So you're saying that the Bible preaches hate and violence?
Well, the Bible...
I don't think I've ever heard a pastor suggesting those words.
Well, unfortunately, you've never probably heard a pastor preach the Bible. But the Bible definitely teaches that God puts all sorts of laws in the Bible and things that people, you know, you cross the line. The Bible puts the death penalty on killing people. The Bible puts the death penalty on kidnapping people. The Bible puts the death penalty on perverted things like homosexuality, bestiality, things of that nature. So you don't hear that because the average church you go to is just interested in getting your money. So they're just going to tell you, you know, they're just going to give you the nice sugar-coated sermons, which is fine, but there's more to the Bible than just those things.
You don't think that you're the only one who shares these beliefs?
Well, I know for a fact that I'm not the only one. I mean, I'm getting a lot of messages of people hating, but I'm getting a lot of messages and phone calls of people saying, I agree with you, people I don't know all over the country, saying thank you for taking a stand. And I know that there are many people out there who agree with what I'm saying, who believe that sodomy is not normal. They think it's disgusting. And I just think it's time for normal people to stand up and say, you know what, enough is enough. Because they're pushing this agenda and they're just trying to, you know, get everyone to just fall in line. And I think it's time for just normal people to say, I'm not saying let's go kill them. I never said that. What I'm saying is it's not a tragedy.
Say, let's line them up against the wall and blow their heads off.
I said if we lived in a country that followed the laws of God, and we lived in a righteous nation that wanted to do what God said, then that's what they would do. Because that's what the Bible says. I know Christians want to ignore that and act like, no, God would never say that. The Bible teaches that. So, you know, as Christians, what I want to say to Christians is, if you say, I'm a Bible-believing Christian, you've got to decide, okay, well, do you believe the whole thing? Or are you just going to ignore certain parts of it?
How long have you been a pastor at this church for?
About 5.5 years.
Okay. Do you think this will change the way you practice?
Not at all. I mean, I believe most of our church people agree with what I'm saying. Most of our church people are normal people that have families and love the Lord and love the Word of God. I don't really see it changing anything. You know, we may lose some people here and there. We'll probably gain some people as a result of it. So,
As far as the church members go, the leadership, are they supporting your remarks?
Yes. Yeah, I'm not having any issues with our church people at all.
Okay.
How large is your church?
We'll have anywhere between 180, 200 people on Sunday morning. So
you just have one service? Or
we have three services a week, Sunday morning, Sunday night, Wednesday night.
And you plan on preaching this Sunday as well?
Absolutely. I will be preaching.
There are some protests scheduled for that day.
I understand that. We're prepared for that. We have a group of men that take care of our security, and they're going to make sure that things... I'm not against people protesting. Unlike the media, I think people have the right to say whatever they want, and people should be able to disagree with me. I don't have an issue with that. We are going to make sure that people are safe and that people aren't harassed and are allowed to come into the church service if they wish to. So, you know, and they're, but we don't mind protesters being there. I will be preaching, and I don't, you know, that's not going to change anything in that aspect. And I would just say, you know, if you are a Bible believing Christian who actually wants to get taught the Bible and not just these sugar coated shallow messages, we'd love to have you at Verity Baptist Church. So
your time.
All right. Well, you have a good day.